हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू मैन्युअर एजुकेशन। सो फाइनली MCA CET 2023 एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म फिलिंग स्टार्ट हो चुका है विद रिगार्ड्स टू द कैप राउंड प्रोसेस। सो जितने भी स्टूडेंट्स वेट कर रहे थे, यस गाइस, एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म की रजिस्ट्रेशन स्टार्ट हो चुकी है फॉर द कैप राउंड। सो यस गाइस, स्टेप बाय स्टेप हम फॉर्म फिलिंग करेंगे एंड विल अंडरस्टैंड ऑल ऑफ द स्टेप्स। ऑल्सो गाइज, इसके पहले वाले वीडियो में वी हैव कवर्ड ऑल द गाइडलाइंस विद रिगार्ड्स टू द एडमिशन प्रोसेस। सो मेक श्योर कि आप वो वीडियो भी एक बार चेकआउट कर लो। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द फॉर्म फिलिंग। सो यस गाइज, आपको सबसे पहले CET सर की ऑफिशियल वेबसाइट पर आ जाना है। यू कैन सी MCA, यहाँ पर आपको एक न्यू ब्लिंक करता हुआ दिख रहा है गाइज। ये अब दिस इज बिकॉज दे हैव स्टार्टेड विद द रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड दिस इज अ रीसेंट अपडेट। सो विल क्लिक हियर and here you can see new candidate registration. Also guys, for the admission notice, if you want to check out, you'll have to click over here on downloads and here you can see admission notice for MCA for academic year 23-24. So yes guys, इस पर इन डिटेल हमने वीडियो ऑलरेडी बनाया है। सो मेक श्योर कि वो वीडियो भी एक बार आप चेकआउट कर लो एंड मेक श्योर टू रीड दिस एंटायर डॉक्यूमेंट ट्वाइस और थ्राइस बिफोर फॉर्म फिलिंग। ऑल्सो गाइज, विद रिगार्ड्स टू द फैसिलिटेशन सेंटर, अभी तक लिस्ट अपडेट नहीं की गई है। दे हैव जस्ट मेड द पोर्टल रेडी बट स्टिल काफ़ी सारी इन्फॉर्मेशन अभी भी इसमें ऐड होनी बाकी है। पोर्टल कंप्लीटली रेडी नहीं हुआ है। सो यस गाइज, यू ऑल हैव टू वेट फॉर द लिस्ट ऑफ फैसिलिटेशन सेंटर। एज यू ऑल कैन सी राइट नाउ देयर इज नो लिस्ट अपडेटेड। सो यस अगेन, यू ऑल हैव टू वेट फॉर दिस। So we'll start with the form filling first. So again, there are some important instructions for login. Here it says use your application ID and password to login. After login, for security reasons, you may change your password. Yes guys, again आपको password भी change करना होगा. But after changing your password, make sure कि आप अपने credentials note down करके याद कर लो कि आपने कहाँ पे आपने note down किया है, because आपके credentials आपके बहुत काम आने वाले हैं till the cap round process. So yes, the change password will be required for your further admission process, that is option form filling, merit display, etc., logging into the system. So yes, make sure कि आप अपने credentials कहीं पर note down करके रख लो जो आपको याद रहे. But in case if you all have forgotten your password, if you tend to forget your password, you all can retrieve your password through forget password link in the bottom. Make sure you log out of your session properly after you have completed your activity, after the form filling and after all the process. Also guys, यहाँ पे हम देख लेते हैं कि कैंडिडेट रजिस्ट्रेशन प्रोसेस कैसे होने वाला है। काफ़ी सिंपल प्रोसेस है गाइज। सो यस, हियर यू कैन सी फर्स्ट कैंडिडेट रजिस्ट्रेशन मीन्स यू हैव टू रजिस्टर योर सेल्फ एंड देन यू विल हैव टू लॉग इन विद द न्यू पासवर्ड विच यू हैव क्रिएटेड। देन यू विल हैव टू फिल द टाइप ऑफ कैंडिडेटो, टाइप डिटेल्स, आपकी कैटेगरी डिटेल्स, क्वालिफिकेशन डिटेल्स ऐड करनी है, आपको पर्सनल डिटेल्स ऐड करनी है, फोटो एंड सिग्नेचर अपलोड करना है, पेमेंट करनी है एंड एप्लीकेशन प्रिंट करना है। एंड देन यू हैव टू विजिट द फैसिलिटेशन सेंटर और इफ़ यू हैव ऑप्टेड फॉर द ई स्क्रूटनी मोड, आप ऑनलाइन आपके डॉक्यूमेंट्स वेरीफाई करवा सकते हो। सो यस गाइस, काफ़ी सिंपल प्रोसेस है। सो विल सी स्टेप बाय स्टेप हाउ टू फिल द एप्लीकेशन फॉर्म। बट बिफोर दैट गाइस, मेक श्योर यू रीड द इन्फॉर्मेशन ब्रोशर केयरफुली। मेक श्योर यू हैव ऑल द सपोर्टिंग डॉक्यूमेंट्स अवेलेबल विथ यू वाइल फॉर्म फिलिंग। बिफोर यू सबमिट योर कैप एप्लीकेशन and confirm your CAP application by the facilitation center, make sure you verify your name, your category, your gender, photo, signature, your marks, name on the mark sheet, as well as any additional information such as the status of EWS, etc. So make sure आपके end से भी एक बार verify कर लो सारा document submit करने से पहले. And also keep checking daily SMS messages on your registered mobile number. Log in to your account and read messages also, because you all will be getting all the important updates over there. Also make sure to check the CET cell official website daily for the latest notifications. Make sure to check the important dates of various activities and complete the activities according to the schedule. So yes guys, they have also released the start date and the end date of the application. Agar aap wo dekhna chahte ho, so guys you all have to check out the admission notice. Yahan pe aap dekh sakte ho guys, dates clearly mention hai. Starting date is 26th of June 2023 and last date is 5th of July 2023 up to 5 PM. This might change guys due to some unavoidable reason, but as of now ye dates declare ki gayi hai guys. And for the document verification, starting date is 26th June 2023 and last date is 6th July 2023 up to 5 PM. Make sure guys aap ye document properly read kar lo form fill karne se pehle. So let's start with the form filling. Sabse pehle guys aapko application ID add kar dena hai yahan pe. Then enter your password, then enter the captcha and click on login. So yes guys, after you complete the new candidate registration, आपके authorized mobile number पर OTP आ जाएगा. You all have to enter that OTP. So once you enter the OTP, here you can see आपको एक unique application ID, एक username मिल जाता है. So make sure कि आप वो कहीं पर note down करके रख लो, बहुत important है. So click here. So yes, you all can start your form filling. So you all can click here to log in your application form. So once we click here, so yes, new candidate registration के बाद जो आपको application ID मिला था guys, you all have to mention that ID over here. Enter your password, enter the captcha and then click on login. So yes guys, make sure to read all the important instruction for admission process. These are those instructions जो अभी हमने form filling शुरू करने से पहले सारे discuss किए थे. So yes guys, make sure to read this out. So yes, here it says you have successfully registered for admission to MCA 2023-24 and your application ID is also mentioned and this application ID will be used throughout the admission process. Also guys, baki sare important message dekhne ke liye you all can click on view all and you all can see over here. Yahan pe aapki login details bhi clearly mention hai guys and your application form status as well. As of now, application form status is incomplete because humne ab tak form fill nahi kiya hai. So let's start with the form filling. So step 1 is fill the registration details which we have already completed. Next, step 2 is fill the CET details. For this, you'll have to click over here, select the scrutiny mode and accordingly select the scrutiny mode, e-scrutiny mode or the physical one. Totally depends upon your choice. Also guys, select karne se pehle ek bar instruction zarur se pad lena. Previous जो हमने वीडियो बनाया था गाइज विद रिगार्ड टू द एडमिशन नोटिस, वी हैव क्लियरली डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर ई स्क्रूनिटी मोड एंड फिजिकल स्क्रूनिटी मोड. सो एज गाइज, वन बाय वन मेक श्योर यू रीड दिस एंड वॉट ऑल रिक्वायर्ड गाइडलाइंस आर देयर. सो अकॉर्डिंगली सिलेक्ट द मोड एज पर योर चॉइस. सो यू विल सिलेक्ट द ई स्क्रूनिटी मोड, विल क्लिक ऑन सेव एंड प्रोसीड. एंड यर इट सेज हैव यू अपियर्ड फॉर महाराष्ट्र MCACET 2023. You'll have to click on yes and then once you click yes, यहाँ पे और दो options open up हो जाता है and the options are for your roll numbers and your registration number. So enter your roll number over here. Next, add your registration number. Next, click on proceed to next. So yes guys, you all can see your details, the candidate details over here, which includes your roll number, your registration number, your CET percentile. Next, click on proceed to next step. Now over here, you can select your candidate or type. So candidates passing SSC or passing diploma in engineering or technology or pharmacy or diploma or vocation or any qualifying examination from a recognized institution in Maharashtra state. Candidate who is either domicile of Maharashtra or is born in Maharashtra. So yes guys, these candidates are type A candidates. So yes, you all can select candidate type A. For type B, candidates who does not fall in type A above but who or whose father or mother is domiciled. If you are not domiciled but your parents are domiciled in the state of Maharashtra and they possess domicile certificate, then you fall in the candidate type B. For candidate type C, a candidate who does not fall either in type A or B but whose father and mother is an employee of Government of India or Government of India undertaking and who has been posted and reported to duty in Maharashtra state before the last date of submitting your application form filling. So yes guys, application form filling ki last date humne dekh liya tha, which is I think 5th of July. So make sure aapke parents ki posting is date se pehle honi chahiye and they should be an employee of the Government of India. Then such type of candidate fall in type C. For candidate type D, a candidate who does not fall in any of the above type A, type B or type C but whose father or mother is an employee or retired employee of Government of Maharashtra. Yahan pe tha guys Government of India, but in type D your mother or father is an employee or retired employee of Government of Maharashtra or Government of Maharashtra undertaking, then such type of candidates will fall in type D. For Maharashtra state candidate type E, candidates passing SSC or passing diploma in engineering or technology or pharmacy or diploma of vocation and also qualifying examination from a recognized institution located in Maharashtra Karnataka border area or from Maharashtra, residing in Maharashtra Karnataka border area and whose mother tongue is Marathi. such type of candidate guys will fall in type E. Candidates who does not satisfy type A, type B, type C or type D or E and having an Indian nationality are eligible under the category of outside Maharashtra students. So such candidates will be considered as OMS students. Jammu and Kashmir Prime Minister Special Scholarship Scheme, which means Jammu and Kashmir cells, deals with implementation of Prime Minister's Special Scholarship Scheme to Jammu and Kashmir students to pursue their studies outside the state of Jammu and Kashmir. So such candidates can click on this option. So over here we'll go with the Maharashtra state time candidate, which is type A. We'll click on save and proceed. Next you'll have to enter all your type details. So here we have already selected as Maharashtra state candidate type A. Also we have discussed about the other options as well. Here select the district from which candidates passing SSC or passing diploma in engineering and technology or pharmacy. So you can select the district. Select district from which candidate has passed appearing for graduation. So yes, once you select the district for your SSC or passing diploma or appearing for graduation, your home university is automatically detected. So our home university is Mumbai University. So over here, as your candidate type is A, you are required to scan and upload any one of the document given below. So whatever candidate type you fall in guys, yahan pe aapke documents accordingly aapse puche jayenge to upload. So yes, select your candidate type as per your documents and then all the required documents you all have to upload one by one. So as we fall in the candidate type A, we have to scan and upload any one of these documents, which is domicile certificate of a candidate indicating that he or she is domiciled in the state of Maharashtra, or birth certificate of the candidate indicating the place of birth in Maharashtra, or the school leaving certificate. So aise hi guys, aap jis bhi candidate type select karoge accordingly aapko documents upload karne ke liye next step mein pucha jane wala hai. So make sure ki aapke paas documents ready rahe. So we'll upload any one of this document. You'll have to first select any option jo bhi aap document upload karne wale ho, then you'll have to click on save and proceed. Next category decision, you'll have to fill in your category details. Here it says, do you belong to general or reserve category? If you all belong to general category, you all can click on general. If reserved, then you all can click on reserved. Once you click on general, guys, yahan pe koi option open up nahi hota hai. The second option which opens up is, do you belong to economically weaker section? So if you all click on the reserve category, yahan pe aur kuch options open up ho jata hai guys. Select the reserve category to which you belong. Select your reserve category, which is DT, VG, VG, NTA, NTA 1, NTA 2, OBC, SBC, SC, ST. So accordingly select your reserve category. Also select reserve subcategory to which you belong. So once you select your reserve category, yahan pe aur kuch options open up ho jata hai guys. You will have to select the subcategory from where you belong. You have to select that particular place. So once you do that, you all are good to go for the next step. Then as you all select your category type, guys, यहाँ पे और भी कुछ options available हो जाते हैं. So over here, for example, if we select the OBC category and we select the sub category over here, यहाँ पे next step हमें पूछ रहे हैं, select status of caste tribe validity certificate. So if you all have the certificate, you all can select available. If you all have applied but you have not received, then you all can click on applied but not received. If you don't have the certificate, you'll have to click on not available. So select accordingly. Then other documents which are required is select status of non-creamy layer certificate. So if you all have the certificate, click on available. If you have applied but not received, you'll have to click on applied and but not received. If you'll have the certificate, if you don't have the certificate, click on not available. So aise hai kuch options hai guys jo aapko one by one fill karne hai. Also yahan pe kuch important instructions bhi diye gaye hai guys with regards to the reserve category. So you are required to scan and upload caste tribe validity certificate at the time of the verification of the security center. यहाँ पे अगर guys, अगर आपके पास में documents certificates available नहीं है but आपने apply किया हुआ है तो आपके पास acknowledgement होगा, receipt होगा. So yes, you all can as of now you all can use that, but at the time of the verification at the scrutiny center, make sure कि आपके पास सारे documents available हो. Also, you're required to scan and upload caste certificate clearly mentioning the category of the candidate and also the remarks that the caste is recognized as a backward class in the state of Maharashtra. So this caste certificate with the caste validity or tribe certificate, दोनों भी documents required है guys, which will act as a proof that you belong to so and so category. Next, you are required to scan and upload non-creamy layer certificate issued by the sub-divisional officer for the deputy collector, officer or deputy collector of the district. So yes, all these documents are required at the time of the verification of the scrutiny center. So yes, we have already discussed about the reserve category details. So over here, we'll be clicking on general and we'll proceed. Next, if you are a person with disability, if no, then you all can click on no. If yes, then you all can click on yes. If you click over here, you all can select the disability type and move ahead. Over here, we'll be clicking on no. Next, certificate for Indian nationality of the candidate. Here it says the candidate must be an Indian national and you are required to scan and upload any one of the following document as a proof of nationality at the time of verification at the scrutiny center. So we'll upload any one of these documents. यहाँ पे जो documents हमें पूछे जा रहे हैं, they are certificate of Indian nationality of the candidate, issued by the Tehsildar Executive Magistrate. Next document is school leaving certificate indicating the nationality of the candidate or the place of birth in India. Next, your birth certificate mentioning your place of birth in India. So इन तीनों में से आप कोई भी एक डॉक्यूमेंट सबमिट कर सकते हो. सारे डॉक्यूमेंट्स गाइस डिफर करेंगे एज पर योर कैटेगरी. सो एज पर योर कैटेगरी मेक श्योर आपके पास आपका डॉक्यूमेंट्स हैंडी हो सो दैट यू ऑल कैन स्टार्ट सिलेक्टिंग एंड अपलोडिंग योर डॉक्यूमेंट्स वन बाय वन. सो ओवर हियर विल सिलेक्ट द बर्थ सर्टिफिकेट एंड सेव एंड प्रोसीड. नाउ क्वालिफिकेशन डिटेल्स. अगेन यहाँ पे कुछ इंपॉर्टेंट इंस्ट्रक्शंस दी गई है विद रिगार्ड्स टू योर 10th एंड 12th मार्क्स डिटेल्स. योर इट सेज फिल योर 10th एंड 12th और इक्विवेलेंट डिटेल्स केयरफुली. कैंडिडेट पास्ट 10th और 12th और इक्विवेलेंट एग्जामिनेशन विल हैव टू स्कैन एंड अपलोड दे आर मार्कशीट एट द टाइम ऑफ द वेरिफिकेशन एट द स्क्रूटिनी सेंटर. यहाँ पे फिलहाल आपको आपके मार्क्स ऐड करने हैं बट ड्यूरिंग योर डॉक्यूमेंट वेरिफिकेशन यू विल हैव टू स्कैन एंड अपलोड ऑल द रिक्वायर्ड डॉक्यूमेंट्स. बट इफ़ यू हैव सेलेक्टेड द फिजिकल डॉक्यूमेंट वेरिफिकेशन सो येस आपको सेंटर पर जाके आपके डॉक्यूमेंट्स वेरीफाई करवाने होंगे. इन केस ऑफ ग्रेड यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रोवाइड द सर्टिफिकेट स्टेटिंग द मार्क्स इक्विवेलेंट टू द ग्रेड अवॉर्डेड बाय द रिस्पेक्टिव इंस्टीट्यूट यूनिवर्सिटी एट द टाइम of the verification of the scrutiny center. In case of range of marks given for the grade, the minimum marks will be considered. In case of candidates who don't have science and mathematics as subject at SSC shall enter marks obtained as 0 marks out of 0. These marks are not mandatory. So yes guys, all the candidates jinhone 10th 12th mein maths and science nahi opt kiya tha, they can enter marks as 0 out of marks as 0. So for them these marks are not mandatory. So yes, according to your qualification, enter the marks obtained out of marks and percentage. So your SSC aggregate. Next, enter your SSC mathematics marks, science. So जैसे जैसे guys आप subjects के marks add करेंगे percentage automatically यहाँ पर convert हो जाएगा आपका. Next, SSC English. Next, your 12th HSC diploma aggregate marks. Next, fill in your graduation marks details. Again, यहाँ पे कुछ important instructions दी गई है guys. Fill your graduation examinations details carefully. Candidates past graduation examination will have to scan and upload their mark sheet at the time of the verification at scrutiny center and must satisfy the eligibility criteria as well. If not satisfied the eligibility criteria, if found any errors, guys, he or she will be considered as not eligible. So make sure guys, form filling आप carefully कर रहे हो step by step. Take your time and fill the form very carefully. And about your graduation marksheet, you'll have to scan and upload your marksheet at the time of the verification. And in case of grades, guys, आपको एक conversion certificate prepare करना होगा so that your grades are converted into marks and accordingly you all can make a conversion certificate. Conversion certificate का भी format, guys, CTCL की official website पे दिया गया. We have also made a video with regards to this, so yes, you all can check that video out as well. So yes, add your graduation marks, select your graduation stream, your graduation university, place of passing, appearing of graduation, if India, then click on India. So yes guys, once you select your graduation university, here I have selected Mumbai University, so yes, I can only select India. Next, graduation type, was it full time, part time or distance education, so select accordingly. Graduation passing year, your graduation status, past or appearing. If appearing, you all can click on appearing. If past, you all can click on past. And if you all click on past, यहाँ पे एक और option open हो जाता है guys, graduation marks types, whether it was in the percentage or CGPA. So if you all click on percentage, यहाँ पे again graduation aggregate marks, यहाँ पे आपको आपके marks add करने हैं and आउट ऑफ मार्क्स एंटर करना है एंड योर परसेंटेज विल बी ऑटोमेटिकली डिटेक्टेड. इफ़ यू आर क्लिकिंग ऑन CGPA, देन अगेन CGPA मार्क्स ऑब्टेन, यहाँ पे आपको एंटर करना है, आउट ऑफ मार्क्स एंटर करना है एंड योर परसेंटेज. एंड इफ़ यू आर क्लिकिंग ऑन अपियरिंग, सो नो फर्दर ऑप्शन विल बी ओपन बिकॉज अभी तक आपका रिजल्ट नहीं आया होगा. सो येस, अपियरिंग इसलिए आपने चूज़ किया है, बट अगर आप पास चूज करते हैं सो अगेन दो ऑप्शन ओपन अप हो जाते हैं, परसेंटेज और यू कैन सिलेक्ट द CGPA. नेक्स्ट, मैथमेटिक्स एट 12th HSC or higher level. If you have studied mathematics at 12th HSC or higher level, then you all can click this option. If no, then you all can click on no. But if you all click on 12th, that yes, you have studied, यहाँ पे option open up हो जाता है guys, subject named, marks obtained, marks out of and percentage. So enter your subject and accordingly enter your marks detail as well. So once done, we'll click on save and proceed. Now you'll have to fill your personal details. So again guys, make sure ये बहुत crucial step है, आप यहाँ पे सारी details properly fill करो. Also guys, make sure to check all the details and verify all the details. It is the sole responsibility of the students and yes, scrutiny center will also check and verify all the details with regards to your name entered for the cap round. And yes, all these details they'll be getting from महाराष्ट्र MCACET डेटा विद द कैंडिडेट अपलोडेड डॉक्यूमेंट्स. सो येस, यहाँ पे आपको आपका नेम ऐड कर देना है गाइज, एंटर एज पर द HSC मार्कशीट. यू हैव टू एंटर योर मदर्स नेम ओवर हियर, डेट ऑफ बर्थ ऐड कर लेना है गाइज, अगेन कंफर्म योर डेट ऑफ बर्थ, सिलेक्ट योर जेंडर. इफ़ यू आर एन ऑर्फन, यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन येस, इफ नो देन क्लिक ऑन नो. बट इफ यू क्लिक ऑन येस, अगेन यहाँ पे कुछ इंस्ट्रक्शन ओपन अप हो जाती है गाइज. यूर इट सेज ओनली महाराष्ट्र स्टेट कैंडिडेट्स आर एलिजिबल फॉर दीज सीट्स. For all the orphan seats, only Maharashtra state candidate students are eligible. You are required to scan and upload performa U for orphan candidates by filling the necessary details, and you all can check the performa U by clicking on this link. So yes guys, all the students, those who are orphan, you all can select this option and you all will be eligible for your required seats. Over here we'll click on no. Then we'll have to add the annual family income, select your religion, select your mother tongue. Next, here it says, do you belong to minority? If yes, then click on yes. If you all click on yes, यहाँ पे आपका minority status पूछा जाता है guys. For linguistic minority, you all can accordingly select the linguistic minority over here from these options. So over here, we'll click on no. Your next option is, do you want to apply for ट्यूशन फी वेवर स्कीम सीट्स? इफ येस, देन यू हैव टू क्लिक ऑन येस. अगेन देर आर सम इंस्ट्रक्शन ओवर हियर. योर इट सेज एलिजिबल महाराष्ट्र स्टेट कैंडिडेट्स विल हैविंग देयर पेरेंट्स एनुअल इनकम फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेज विच इज लेस देन 8 lakh. ओनली दीज स्टूडेंट्स इज एलिजिबल फॉर द TFWS सीट्स. यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू सबमिट एन इनकम सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ पेरेंट्स इशूड बाई द कॉम्पिटेंट अथॉरिटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट मैंशनिंग the family income which is below 8 lakh rupees and it should be valid till 31st March 2023 at the time of verification at scrutiny center. So these are the two important instructions which needs to be fulfilled if you all want to apply for the TFWS scheme. So over here we'll click on no. Next, add in your address, whether your permanent address is in urban or rural area. then you all can select accordingly. Mention your address over here. Next, add in your details. Next, select the state, district, select your taluka, select village or city. Over here, your contact details. So your mobile number is already mentioned over here. Add any alternate mobile number. Next, your email ID is already added over here. You can even add your telephone number. It's optional. Next, we'll click on save and proceed. Now, over here, you all have to upload your photograph with a signature. Again, guys, यहाँ पे कुछ important instructions दी गई है. Here it says recent color photo with signature of candidate taken within last 3 months. So आपका photo recent होना चाहिए guys. एकदम ही ज़्यादा पुराना photo यहाँ पे upload मत कर देना जो कि clear और visible ना हो. Photograph must be 3.5 cm in width and 4.5 cm with height without border. Photograph has to be taken with full face without headgear unless the applicant habitually wears a headgear in accordance with his or her racial religious custom, but the headgear should not hide the applicant features. So yes guys, even if you are wearing a headgear, make sure that your face and features are clearly visible. Also guys, baki sari bhi details yahan pe mention hai, ek bar read kar lena guys. Also guys, the photo which you all will be uploading should be in a JPG, GIF or a PNG file. So over here we'll click on choose file. So over here we'll upload our photograph. Okay, so if you all want to retake the same photo, you all can retake it, but we'll just click on upload photo. So over here we'll click on save and proceed. Now here it says that upload the documents, and yahan pe guys aapka application or username bhi mention hoga. Yahan pe again kuch important instructions available hai guys. Upload scanned documents, please click on submit button after uploading all your scanned documents to view printable application form. So yes guys, sare documents aapko scanned upload karne hain, and yes before and yes once you upload the documents, click on the submit button as well. Upload the documents in JPG or PNG or PDF format, minimum 150 dpi resolution, file size should be up to 1 MB. Right tick indicates document uploaded by the candidate, and the wrong tick indicates documents not uploaded by the candidates. Also, college school leaving certificate, transfer certificate, other passing qualifying examination is not mandatory to upload, but if it is selected for minority document purpose, then it is mandatory. Also, if candidate do not possesses the document, the document scrutiny center shall select the document as non-submitted or non-accepted and confirm the candidate as well. Also, candidate need to submit this document at the time of admission while institute reporting. So make sure guys, documents ko leke delay bilkul nahi karna hai. Documents ko leke yahan sari cheez ab bahut hi zyada strict aur disciplined way mein rehne wali hai. So usko leke bilkul bhi delay mat karna. Make sure aapke sare documents aapke paas ready ho. Isliye humne sare documents ke video sabse pehle cover kiya tha guys, registration shuru hone se pehle. So just jin bhi students ke paas required documents nahi hai, wo documents banwa sake. So make sure aapke paas sare documents ready hone chahiye guys. So over here, list of documents required to be uploaded. So one by one we'll upload all the documents. Statement of marks obtained at 10th or its equivalent examination. So once you upload the documents, here you can see the status shows a green tick, which means the documents is uploaded. And if you all want to view, you all can click on view and you all can check over here the document which you have uploaded. Next, we'll do the same for the other documents as well. We'll start uploading the documents one by one. Next document is 12th mark sheet, birth certificate. Guys, ye documents differ karega because guys, this document might differ from candidate to candidate because आप अपनी category candidate type select करने वाले हो. So yes, make sure कि आपके पास आपके सारे documents ready रहे इस समय upload करने के लिए at this stage. So yes, once done with uploading all the documents, we'll click on submit and here you go. This is the printable application form. You all can even print this application form. आपकी सारी details यहाँ पे available है guys. Make sure that ये application form आपके पास till the end रहे because ये application form बहुत काम आने वाला है. Make sure to take a printout of this application form. And ये application form guys आपके सारे important documents के साथ आप एक ही साथ ये file में रख लेना, so that सारे documents आपको एक साथ काम आने वाला है at the time of your document verification. So yes guys, that was it for this form filling video. I hope this video was helpful and I hope कि and I hope that you all will fill your form without any errors. Still guys, notification instructions जो भी आपको दिए गए हैं, take your good time and read the instructions and guidelines carefully twice or thrice before the form filling and then आप form filling करना start करना. Also guys, अगर form filling को लेकर कोई doubt and query है, you all can definitely comment in the comment section below या आप हमें नीचे दिए गए Capround के number पर भी call करके connect कर सकते हो. We'll definitely help you out with the form filling process. Also guys, with regards to the podcast, we have also mentioned a Google form link in the description. All the students who have cleared MCACET can definitely join us for the podcast series where we have a conversation about their preparation strategy, about their exam writing experience. Yes guys, bahut zyada interesting conversation hoga aapka hamare mentors ke sath. So yes guys, you all can join us for the podcast series as well. Link description mein hai guys. Make sure that you fill out the form and a team will get back to you with your podcast schedule. So yes guys, that was it for this video. I hope this video was helpful and in case of any doubt and query, feel free to reach out to us. Also guys, aise hi sare updates ke video, important videos dekhne ke liye sabse pehle hamare channel pe bane rahiye hamare sath Maneuver MC entrance pe, and until then guys, I will see you in the next video.